Can you invest in Britannia stock? Do you eat Britannia stock biscuits? I love it. All the things and cakes and especially all the premium things. I love Britannia stocks. So hi, hello, this is Ganesan Thiru, your stock market profit coach. I help in multiplying your money by investing in stock market, and this is my book, One Page Stock Market Plan. Please go and check it out so that you will also able to do all these fundamental analysis by yourself, right? And if you are interested to participate in my webinar to do all these analysis by yourself, please click the description. You will be able to do all the. Please attend one free webinar. You will know how to do these things. So, what is that Britannia stock and how you can do that? Just go and check it out in the screener website. We all know Britannia is one of the oldest brand, and but it has all the issues with respect to who is owning the company and all these things. I think till 1999 or 2000, and after that, the Wadia Group took over the company and the brand, and almost they turned around the company from nowhere. Britannia has become almost the we know only few biscuits, Milk Bikis, Good Day, and all these things. But they've taken all these biscuits to the next level, and it has become a premium. Everybody started loving the brand just because of the focus on launching new products again and again. I mean, every 3 months they had a plan and they launched the products. And this is also because of the new change in management, which happened not now, a couple of years ago. I think in 2013 or even before that. Varun Berry was he was appointed as a managing director and CEO, and he turned around the company like anything, like what happened in HUL, right? Yesterday you had seen the video, right? And today it's all about this company and is it good to invest in the right now in the present scenario? Let me show you the same thing. You can go and check it out in the screener.in. Go on input Britannia, you will get the data. Just look at the market cap is more than 84,000 crores. And the current price is 3,501. Just don't go by the stock price, but just go by the fundamentals whether this company is good to invest or not. Okay. And if you look at the ROE, it's 47 return on equity. Wow. And return on capital employed is 45.4. Awesome. Right. One another big thing. And the ROCE for the last 5 years, it is 44.3, which is really good. Any company which is having ROE, ROC more than that, it's a very good company to invest. And just look at the free cash flow in the last 3 years is 3,600 crores. And the current price to earning ratio is 45.2, right? This is the current PE ratio. And the market cap we know, and the industry PE ratio is 53.7. This is an interesting point to note that, right? We will come back to the all these industry PE things, but let's look at the Britannia as an industry with a 100-year legacy. Again, it's a very old company. If you're a beginner, these are the kind of companies you should look at investing. And just look at the excess of 9,000 crores, the revenues, annual revenue in excess of 9,000 crores. This is the most important aspect if anybody's investing in a stock or if you're even planning to buy out a company. And this is one interesting factor you should look at before investing. And you all know these brands, right? Good Day, Tiger Biscuits, NutriChoice, Milk Bikis, and Marigold, which are household names. Because if you are sugar patient, people will say go and eat Marigold often. If you're a kid, you will be offered Tiger Biscuits and nice the biscuit with peppered with sugars. You can eat that. And Good Day, everybody will love that. So all these for all age groups, you have biscuits and you will eat it. And the new variants of new premium biscuits, and it has taken the market by surprise, and it was so good and people love it. I love it personally. And this is a Bombay Burma Trading Corporation owned by Wadia Group. And just look at the way this company has grown. This is the kind of stock you should also hold upon. And we all know the Britannia breads are there, biscuits, cakes, and rusk. All these are good, and they are also into dairy products, and they are started exporting as well. To most into Gulf countries and UAE, they are number two, and slowly they are expanding in all the Gulf countries as well. And they set up a manufacturing base in Nepal, and they are expanding the manufacturing capacity in, I think, in Maharashtra. Recently, they set up. Okay, just look at the last 5 years' data, the kind of stock growth we had seen in Britannia over a period of time, the last 5 years. Okay, let's look at the PE ratio for last 5 years. PE ratio on an average was around 56. Right now it is around just 45, right? Just keep that in mind. And just look at the PE ratio for last 15 years from the time of 2007. It is around 44.6. So it says that in the last 5 years, the company has improved. The sales had improved, the earnings per share had improved. So the PE ratio also improved. So it's performing higher. So considering this PE ratio and considering the current economic situation, it says that only the defensives are coming back compared to the metals and banking. Now defensives will make a comeback in the few in the coming days. So, and if you look at Britannia as a stock in the in this week alone, from the bottom it has went up to 3500. It went down almost up to 3410 or something, but it went up to 3500 in a span of couple of days. So almost 3% returns in this 1 week. And if you look at it, is a lowest PE right now. And if the the current economic cycle is focusing on FMCG, this company will make a strong comeback. Compared to the PE ratio of the last few years, this stock is very much looks positive to invest. Let's look at the compared to Nestle, which is at the PE of 76.91, and even Britannia has traded at a very high value in the last few years. Let's look at the PE ratio of in July 2020 at its peak, because that is a timeline. During the lockdown, it went down to 44.8. This is the average PE ratio even during the last market crash. If you look at in the again, it started climbing up from the down of 44.8. It started climbing up in July and all, it went up to 63.9, and that is a timeline between April, May, June. We had complete lockdown. Only in June it started opening. So that is the time it started picking out, and now again we are in lockdown and the sales can happen. Anybody who is venturing out, they'll always go for biscuits, snacks and everything, so that they are eating to something in the home, right? Even I look forward, even you will look forward to it, right? So this is the kind of company which can see a comeback. It can go up, it can give you immediate return maybe in the next few months, on the next few quarters. So this is something like you should also look towards before for investing. And again, just look at Nestle is trading at around 76, and it started improving only in the last few years. So compared to Britannia, it is in the same segment, food processing MNC, though, right? Britannia is mostly into biscuits. Nestle is completely different, coffee and everything mixed, but still they are grouped under. Let's look at the EPS in the last few years. Just look at the growth. No, March 2020 it was 58, and March 2021 it was 77.38. The EPS had increased, the sales had increased from 11,600, the sales had increased. The just look at the operating profit has increased, the operating profit margin is 19%. Everything is looking going good for this company. And in the last 5 years, from 2016, the EPS had increased consistently over a period of time. In the last 5 years, EPS had consistently increased. Considering this scenario and considering the current market condition, which says that defensives can make a comeback under this thing, defensives can make a comeback, means you can look at investing in Britannia as a stock, because it's based on the current economic cycle. Maybe going forward you can look at, and valuations looks good based on the valuation. Don't just go by the stock price, which says that it is 3500, it's expensive. Okay, stock price valuation depends upon how far the stock is there compared to the earnings of the company, compared to the way the stock can grow in the future. Based on these factors, it looks good. And even in the future, will there be competition? Yes, but if you look at all these, there are market for everybody. And ITC has a Sunfeast biscuits. Apart from them, if you look at Britannia, occupies a major shelves. And there are local brands all across India, but this is spread across. Britannia spread across, and the Marigold, all the biscuits are household names. Everybody will go towards. Every Mary is not Mary. I think sometime they gave in the ad like that. And Milk Bikis, they had caught the eyes of everybody. Everybody loves Milk Bikis, and that to kids. Tiger Biscuit, Milk Bikis are favorites for kids, most of the kids. So they're maintaining the position, and they're launching premium biscuits, premium new varieties and all these things every now and then. And I think they launched the croissant, one more baking variety. They're getting into bakings also, along with cakes. They launched cakes. I love the Britannia cakes, and then the croissants, that is also good. So all these makes an interesting case about Britannia as a company. And looking at the point, like they are increasing the manufacturing capacity during this timeline, says that they are something looking at growth, next level growth. So those kind of companies will do all these activities. So can you invest? Maybe yes. And this is not a stock recommendation. I'm putting a disclaimer. This is don't come back and say that I invested based on your advice And right, this is not a stock advisory, this is not a recommendation. This is how you should do the stock analysis. And I just gave a sample of how to do the analysis, right? So just go and check it out whether this company is good to invest or not. If you believe in Britannia, right, just go and check it out and then do your investments. Investment should be based on your own consciousness, not based on that. And if you're interested to do all these kind of analysis by yourself, please come and check out my free webinar. It is happening on, you can come and register. I'll be sending out the webinar link so that you can participate next. Thank you so much for watching. Please share this video with your friends. If you feel this analysis you can also do, you want to do, because this is most important, more than technicals. If you analyze the fundamentals, that is more than enough to make money, right? Make money and create wealth in a span of 2 to 3 months very easily. This is what I teach in my webinars also. Please come and join, see how it works. Thank you.